quick introduction to electrophilic aromatic substitution. So, electrophilic aromatic substitution involves using an electrophile to substitute one of the positions on an aromatic ring. In our case, we're going to use benzene and an unspecified electrophile. We're going to draw out one of the resonance forms of benzene. We know that these are actually resonating around, and sometimes you'll see benzene represented using this. That's perfectly acceptable normally, but it won't help us draw out our mechanism. So, draw it with the double bonds in place, and the first thing that's going to happen is that if this is our electrophile, our nucleophile is going to attack it. So, break this carbon-carbon double bond and form a new carbon-electrophile bond. And let's look at what we've made. This is quite an energetically expensive step because this is all the benefits of aromaticity, and if we look at what we've made, we can see that we lose aromaticity. So things are aromatic if they obey Huckel's rule, and we can see that this is no longer going to obey Huckel's rule. It's no longer going to be a ring that has a p orbital on every single substituent. So let's draw out everything that we had except for the things that have been moved by arrows. So all of those bonds have to still be there. And now what we did was we took this pair of electrons and we moved them from here into a new carbon electrophile bond, which means that this carbon here now has a positive charge on it. So this isn't aromatic. It's got a positive charge. I'll just extend that bond there. Not aromatic, has a positive charge in a carbon, not tremendously stable. Usually, if we were just adding across a double bond, if this wasn't in an aromatic system, a nucleophile would come along and attack the carbocation and we'd have added across a double bond. But in this case, elimination is much, much more favorable because you restore aromaticity. So we can take this pair of electrons, restore aromaticity by recreating a carbon-carbon double bond, and see what we have. So everything that was there has to still be there. We haven't moved it using an arrow. And we took the pair of electrons that was in this carbon-hydrogen bond away from that carbon-hydrogen bond and made a new carbon-carbon double bond. So that hydrogen has now lost its share of a pair of electrons. It's now positively charged. And if we look at the net effect, we've just replaced the hydrogen with the electrophile. The hydrogen now has a positive charge. So we'll have a look in a minute as to what those electrophiles might be. But over here we generated a carbocation. And carbocations, as we know, are very unstable, high energy species to generate. This happens a little bit more easily than it would for generating just a normal secondary carbocation. And the reason for that is that this can resonate around. And that resonance is going to become important later on when we start looking at other things. So there's no reason that we can't move this pair of electrons from here to here. And if we do that, what's going to happen? Well, draw it out again. That bond is still there. Those bonds are still there. We took this pair of electrons here and moved it here, and the positive charge is now located down there. And that, of course, can resonate further. So we can move our double bond across, we can move that pair of electrons and create a double bond from this carbon to this carbon. And if we look at what happens when we do that, everything that is in this step has to be in this step, and every bond that doesn't have an arrow going from it has to still be in existence because we haven't moved it. So let's draw them all out. That double bond has no arrows anywhere near it, so it has to still be there. We took this pair of electrons that was here and we've moved it across into a new carbon-carbon bond here. And so this carbon with this hydrogen on it now has a positive charge on it. And ultimately then, we can do the elimination both ways. So it can eliminate out on this side either, and we get to the same product. This hydrogen will lose its share of that pair of electrons and will reform carbon-carbon double bond, and we'll end up with much the same product. Although you might rightly point out that we're looking at a different resonance form if you follow those arrows exactly. Nonetheless, it turns out that this is going to be important. So later on, it's going to be important that the positive charge can reside here, or here, or here, but the positive charge never resides here, or here, or here. Okay, let's look at a specific example. Our specific example is going to be nitrobenzene, where we've substituted one of the hydrogens for a nitro group. To make that happen, we're going to have to generate a strong electrophile. Our electrophile is going to have to be NO2 plus. And we'll see why the positive charge is on the nitrogen now. To do that, the usual thing to use, although there are many different possible conditions, are sulfuric acid and nitric acid. So nitric acid is HNO3. And sulfuric acid is H2SO4. So that's what they look like. Sulfuric acid is such a strong acid that it will protonate nitric acid if you have the two of them concentrated in solution. What's that protonation going to look like? Well, the lone pair from one of these oxygens, and if we use this oxygen here, you'll see what happens. The lone pair from one of these oxygens is going to take a hydrogen and leave behind a sulfate, or leave behind a negative charge on the sulfate. And if we look at that, well, we can ignore this half of the molecule, we're not so interested. What we are interested is the fate of the nitrate, or of the nitric acid. So all of these things are still unchanged. And you'll see nitrogen has four bonds to it, it has a positive charge on it. We can't make a fifth bond to it because it's only got four orbitals. It's in the second row of the periodic table. And we've made a new bond from this oxygen to a hydrogen. So this oxygen is now positively charged. And we have water could act as a leaving group if this oxygen can take this pair of electrons, which of course it can, because this nitrogen with a negative charge can form a double bond, push the electrons out like that. What do we have now? Well, if we follow those, what we have made is NO2 plus, because this has gained a pair of electrons, but it's also lost a pair of electrons, so it still has a net positive charge, and nitrogen with four bonds to it is positively charged, and we've made water. And our reaction conditions, if it's concentrated sulfuric acid, are going to react with that water and mop it up. And it's not going to be around to reverse that reaction. So we now have an extremely strong electrophile in our reaction. And if we put in, or if we draw in benzene, then exactly the same reaction that happened last time when we looked at electrophilic aromatic substitution is going to happen this time. The mechanism is identical, except that we have to account for what bonds are formed to this nitrogen. So we take this pair of electrons, attack the nitrogen, and we have to push two electrons out onto an oxygen. What's that going to look like? And I'm going to get rid of the water now. The water's gone, erased from the reaction. We're not interested in it anymore. But if we look at this, it's exactly the same as when we used our generic electrophile. So these are all still here. I haven't drawn in the hydrogens. I will now draw in one of these hydrogens. I will obey my own rules and follow the bonds exactly as they were. This bond is now gone. We've made a new bond from there to the nitrogen, and we made that into a single bond. So we took that pair of electrons, put it in here, took that pair of electrons, put it out onto this nitrogen, and of course that double bond to an oxygen is still there. So it's still a positive charge on that nitrogen, but we also have a positive charge on this carbon down here. And you say, well, how can we have more positive charges? Well, the net charge is still the same because this positive and negative cancel each other out. So a net positive charge here, net positive charge here. What happens next? The same thing that always happens in electrophilic aromatic substitution: eliminate the hydrogen and reform aromaticity. And yes, this can resonate, but we won't worry about that right now. So what does that look like in the end? Well, draw out everything exactly as it was. Don't get caught out not obeying your own rules. took that pair of electrons, put it into this double bond, and this hydrogen is now bereft of its electrons, so it's now H+. So we just did exactly what we did in the last mechanism. We took an electrophile, NO2+, and we substituted one of the hydrogens for that NO2+. And now we have, as described, nitrobenzene. Okay, if you have any questions, post them below or ask me in lectures. That's all for now. Bye.